Welcome to another episode of our live stream, My Journey to the Trinity. My name is Kasim. I'm real happy to be with you. And we have a real special friend today who's with us. We're going to be talking in Arabic, but I'll be translating. So he'll speak and then I'll translate. We're going to be bilingual today here. So welcome. دكتور محمد رحومه.
اهلا صديقي العزيز. شوف هي اللغه العربيه بتاعتك لايك ماي انجلش، فما حدش النهارده يعني احنا بنكمل بعض النهارده. هللويا.
احنا كثير مبسوطين انك تكون معنا اليوم، واحنا كثير اشياء حابين نسالك، بس حابين أول شيء نعرف عن خلفيتك، نعرف عن قبل ما جيت للرب، حابين نعرف عنك شو كان حياتك في مصر قبل ما جيت للرب. وخليني بس أترجم هذا للإنجليزي. I just want to I asked Dr. Muhammad Rahuma who about his previous life before he came to the Lord, before he knew the Lord Jesus Christ. He was very active. He was Muslim and is very active in Egypt in the educational Islamic system. And so we just want to find out a little bit about his background before we talk about what he's doing now. اتفضل الدكتور وخليها بس هيك مقطع مقطع مشان اترجمها
جمل قصيرة. أكيد ناس كتير شافت قصتي، بس أنا أقول أنا كنت عميد كلية الدراسات العربية والإسلامية، وكان عندي مناصب.
Okay, but let me just say, he used to be the dean of the College of Arabic and Islamic Studies في أي جامعة؟
جامعة الأزهر فرع المنيا.
For the Al-Azhar University. He's an Azhari, you guys. He's one of them. I'm just kidding. In Al-Minya, which is one of the large centers, like states in Egypt, Al-Minya.
Yes. وكان عندي كل ما أريد. يعني كنت مكانة وجاب وجود جاب وكل حاجة وفلوس كل حاجة كل شيء. أنا كان عندي كل شيء. كل ما يريده إنسان، يعني كنت أزهر عميد كلية.
Yeah. I had everything that anybody could possibly want in my country. I was Azhari. Azhari meaning that he was among the Muslims. This is a very high position to be a graduate, to be and working with the Azhari University. The Azhar, for those of you who don't know, is almost the equivalent of like the Vatican for the Catholics. Al-Azhar is the number one educational institution for Sunni Islam. It's extremely important. And so he had everything that anybody could want. He had a great job, making lots of money, lots of respect, lots of, very respected position in Egypt.
كان بيتخرج على إيدي كل سنة. ألف إمام جامع وشيخ.
Wow. Based on what he was doing, there were 1,000 new imams every year.
Uh-oh.
Every year he would produce 1,000 new Muslim imams, Sunni imams, to spread the Islam throughout the world.
هذا معناه هذا معناه إن أنا مسؤول ولا أهرب من مسؤوليتي، مسؤول عن الإرهاب ليا، مسؤولية عن الإرهاب اللي بيعملوه إخواتنا في كل العالم الآن.
In this sense, you could say I was also responsible for the terrorism.
Uh-oh.
The terrorism that some of these my students went on to promote and commit, I'm partially responsible for it.
لكن ربنا يعلم كنت مسلم بإخلاص.
But our Lord knows that I was a very sincere Muslim.
وكنت بحب محمد.
and I used to love Muhammad.
وكنت بحب القرآن مع إني.
And I loved the Quran.
مع إني بأعطي ماجستير ودكتوراه فيه بس مش فاهمه.
I had a master's degree. I had a doctorate degree, PhD in Quran, and I still didn't understand it.
مش أنا تلاميذي.
And my students.
يا تلاميذي أنا كنت أمنح الماجستير والدكتوراه.
I used to be the one who actually granted them master's degrees. I used to grant them doctorate degrees, even though I myself didn't understand.
أنا فاكر رسالة الدكتوراه عن بلاغة القرآن. دي آخر رسالة ناقشتها سنة 2001 قبل ما أجي.
Okay.
قبل ما أجي أمريكا.
I remember the very last master's degree.
No, doctorate.
Oh, doctorate degree that I oversaw, and it was about the rhetoric of the Quran. This was in the year 2001.
When I am still, أنا لسه فاكر my student. His name is Atif from Somalot, Armenia.
Okay, and the student who wrote this doctorate, who presented it, his name was Shukanismo?
Atif.
Atif.
Atif Kamal. Atif Kamal.
Atif Kamal from Somalot, Armenia.
Armenia, yes.
Okay.
ودي آخر دكتوراه ناقشتها قبل ما أجي أمريكا سنة 2001.
This was the last doctorate PhD that I presented before I came to the United States in 2001.
بس أنا فاكر في مناقشة الدكتوراه بيبقوا ثلاث أساتذة، المشرف اللي هو أنا ورئيس اللجنة لازم يكون فول بروفيسور وعضو تاني بيناقش. أنا أذكر إحنا الخمسة والطالب ما كناش فاهمين حاجة، يعلم ربنا ما كنا نفهم شيء.
And I remember that in the doctorate, you know, it's kind of like there were five people involved in the granting of this PhD, and Dr. Muhammad was the chief. He was the chief of the five who were there. The other was a student, and then the other three were professors, and we were there discussing the subject of his PhD thesis. But the problem is, none of us knew what the heck we were talking about.
This is not comedy.
That, you know, this isn't intended to be comical, but there is no logic or rhetoric in the Quran. And that's what this thesis was about.
ليست بلاغة لكنها بلاهة you know بلاهة
no rhetoric but there is chaos
بلاهة يعني عبط
there's folly in it
full yes yeah المهم كنت أبحث عن كنت عندي كل ده لكن أبحث عن شيء يعرفوه المسيحيين ويعرفوه المؤمنين عن علاقة خاصة بيني وبين الله اللي أنا لازم أحبه مش أخاف منه.
The thing that I wanted and what I was looking for even at that time is I was looking for something that the Christians had, which is a relationship with God. I wanted to have a personal relationship with God.
ما حدش يفهم الكلام ده من المسلمين. Nobody can understand this from My Muslims people, مش فاهمين الكلام ده ما يفهموهوش.
None of the Muslims understand this. None of the Muslims understand this idea of having a personal relationship with God.
ده بالعكس ده يعتبروني كافر.
They started considering me a kafir, which is, you know, an unbeliever, but also it's a very serious word, especially when you're a dean of an Al-Azhar college. You know, and so they start considering him a kafir or an unbeliever, a heretic.
لأنما لاحظت إن كل زملائي وكل اللي في الحقل الإسلامي بيعمل حاجتين.
I noticed that all of my colleagues in this field, educational field, that they do two things.
يسد أذانه حتى لا يسمع.
They close their ears.
ويغمض عينه حتى لا يرى.
And they close their eyes so they can't see.
وبالتالي ما في مخ، في بسطرمة.
And because of this, there's no brain. There's only pastrami.
أنا كنت كده أضحك على عليهم. أنا كنت كده. بالنعمة خلصنا.
I'm not laughing at them. I was the same situation.
Yeah. بل يمكن يكون كنت أسوأ كمان منهم.
And I was worse than them.
Yeah. طبعا القصة طويلة، لكن أنا لا أريد أن أستغرق في المعاناة.
I don't want to get drowned, get stuck in the suffering.
وأنا أبحث عن الإله الحقيقي.
And I was looking for the true God.
ما كنتش واثق في إله الإسلام خالص.
I didn't trust the Islamic God at all.
وكنت تعبان من فكرة إن أنا ممكن أنام وما أمش من النوم وأروح جهنم.
And I was very worn out by the thought that I might go to sleep and not wake up and end up in hell.
وبعدين نفس الـ الصحابة سألوا محمد عن معنى هذه الآية من القرآن.
And the companions, if you look in, there were some of Muhammad's who asked Muhammad about a particular verse in the Quran.
Yeah.
إيش
الآية؟ الآية بتقول، الآية صعبة شوية. ما منكم إلا واردها، قالوا سألوه حتى أنت يا رسول الله، قال حتى أنا إلا أن تدركني رحمة الله. واردها means go to hell for some time.
There is a famous verse in the Quran that says, there is none of you but who will go to hell. You will go to hell for a short amount of time, maybe. There is none of you but who will go to hell. This is a verse in the Quran. I'm going to pull up right now and I'll show it to you. Everybody's going to go to hell. Okay. The Quran says this. And then the companions asked Muhammad and they said, even you, Prophet of Allah, peace be upon you? And he said, even me.
بلاش الكومبينيون، خليها الصحابة. الصحابة or his disciples. الصحابة أو disciples، مش أصحابه، لا، دول الخاصة. دول الديفيشال بيبول.
اوكي.
تمام.
تلاميذه
اللي معاه في مسؤولية الدعوة. المهم، وطبعا غير كمان عذاب القبر.
And this is in addition to the teachings about the torments of the grave.
ده صورة مفزعة، مؤلمة، كل ما افتكرها جسمي خشول.
This is such a terrifying picture. Every time I even think about it, my body still trembles a little.
كل المسلمين مثقفين أو جهلة أو علماء، كلهم خايفين من حاجة اسمها عذاب القبر.
All the Muslims, whether they're educated or uneducated, how committed or how uncommitted they are, they're all afraid of the torments of the grave.
دي العصا بتاع محمد اللي أرهب بها المسلمين.
This is the stick, the rod with which Muhammad terrified the Muslims.
To deceive them, لخداعهم وإقناعهم أنهم follow him، يمشوا وراه.
This is also to terrify them and to to deceive them and force them to follow him, to convince them to follow him. And by the way, there's several of you who have been giving giving super chats. Thank you so much for that. Thank you for everybody.
Thank you, Mr. Salibi Thabit. عندك أصحاب حلوين زي العسل أهو. المهم، كانت النتيجة، الله، طب وبعدين يا ربي، أنا ما كنت سعيد يا أخويا ستيف. ما 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 ما, ما كنتش ما ما كنتش ببتسم ما كنتش بضحك.
Okay.
يعني
so what happened is that I was so unhappy. I couldn't smile. I couldn't laugh. I was so under the oppression of these beliefs. First of all, everybody's going to go to hell, and then we got to also deal with the torments of the grave.
أنا عندي مفاجأة حلوة. أنا هوريك صورتي وأنا مسلم عشان تعرف شوف كنت إيه من 30 سنة. يعني مفروض شباب وحلو وسيم.
بس ما تكونش أحلى مني يعني.
لا مش أحلى منك.
Okay. He's going to show us a picture. He's got a surprise for. He's going to show us a picture of when he was very handsome and young, and when he was the dean of the college. And by the way, you guys, if you would like a little description of the torments of the grave, please write that. I'm not sure if we need to talk about that, but if you would like us to, just ask a little bit about the torments of the grave, and we could. Dr. Muhammad, ممكن بس تحكي لنا جملتين
ماشي.
عذاب القبر.
عذاب القبر هو يا اخي ما تفكرنيش يا عمي، خلاص ربنا شفاني. يقول لك
I ask him about the torments of the grave. He says oh don't remind me, the Lord healed me of it.
But
أنا ممكن أحكي حاجة شوية عنه بس.
لكن لا أقول هو يحطوك في القبر ويمشوا، فحوائط القبر تفضل تضيق عليك لغاية ما تفتت عظامك، تطبق عليك وتفتت عظامك. دي واحد.
Okay, the first thing that happens with the torments of the grave. Now I know a lot of you already know about this, but let me just say a little bit because it is. You know the reason that I care about this is because I remember when my dad was Muslim. I remember when he was old and he would go to the mosque and then the sheikh would start screaming about the torments of the grave. And my poor dad, he was 86 years old. He was so scared. He'd come home shaking because of what the sheikh was saying in the mosque about the torments of the grave. What they say, they put you inside the coffin and then they start the box starts squeezing until it crushes your bones.
That's
the first step, is that the coffin squeezes you until it crushes your bones.
دي صورتي من 25 سنة.
This is my picture 25 years ago. أي واحد أنت؟
الأول واحد ده.
على.
اللي حاطط إيدي كده وكرفتة خضراء أعتقد.
The one with the green. خليها شوي لهيك. مشان إحنا لا هيك. أيوة. Okay, this is the one with the green, the long green tie.
أيوة. Yes. وده محافظ المنيا وده المحامي العام للمنيا.
And this is the.
Governor. Yeah.
Wow.
واخد بالك؟ شفت ده شكله اهو.
اوكي
اهو.
اه there he is again.
اها انا جنب رولا خرصه، دي رولا خرصه الصحفيه المعروفه.
اوكي this is a very famous, he's next to the lady with red hair, her name is Rula. She's a very famous journalist in Egypt.
Yes. يعني انا بدور مش ممكن اهو. شوف وانا بقى من 20 سنة، لا دي 30 40 سنة.
This is like 40 years ago. أي واحد أنت؟
أنا اللي لابس البدلة ده الأمور ده.
I'm the cute one. I'm the cute one and the tall one and the cutest one.
ودي بص دي بقى دي باينة فيها قوي. بص حد يقول ده أنا ده أنا ده.
أي واحد أنت؟
ده اللي بكلم الوزير ده الوزير مفيد شهاب وزير التعليم. Okay. وده انا بكلمه اللي مايل شويه كده بوريه.
To the minister of education in Egypt is yeah. Very high position he was. Wow.
يعني بصوا اللي يشوف الصوره الان ما يصدقش ايه ده انا ده المسيح. المسيح خلانا حلوين فعلا.
You look at me now and you say it can't be the same person, and it's because of Jesus. Jesus has made me beautiful. He's made me able to laugh. He's made me able to smile.
نمرة واحد الاسكويز الجسم. نمرة اثنين الثعبان الأقرع.
الثعبان.
والثعبان الأقرع ده ثعبان ضخم جدا وبيمص الدم ويفضل يعذب في الجثه لغايه ما هو ميت، هيعمل فيه ايه تاني؟ هيموته تاني؟
So what the next thing after the coffin squeezes you to crush your bones, then there's this huge serpent that comes. It's called the bald serpent. And so this serpent was huge and it comes and it sucks your blood.
ثالث حاجة بقى ناكر ونكير.
And then you guys, the joy of the one of the greatest torments of the grave is ناكر and نكير.
مسكين مطارق من حديد وينزلوا فيه.
They got steel hammers and they come to beat you with these huge steel hammers.
لغايه ما يخلصوا عليه. طب ما هو ميت هيخلصوا عليه.
They come to torment him. He's already dead. Are you trying to kill him again?
أفكر his flesh جسمه يذوب ويبقى تراب. يروح ربنا إله الإسلام السادي اللي بيحب العذاب يخلقه تاني من جديد عشان يبدأ الكر مرة أخرى.
Okay, after he has been tormented and he's been his body's destroyed and from all of these torments, and Allah in his mercy will recreate the person so they can start the torments all over again.
حلوة قوي حلوة قوي.
And I just want to say you guys, I know this sounds insane, it sounds crazy, but I know people are scared.
كل الناس مصدقه، كل المسلمين مصدقين عذاب القبر.
All the Muslims believe in this and they are terrified.
ومحمد في الاحاديث قال عنه عن عذاب القبر.
I know little kids who used to not be able to sleep at night because the sheikh would come over to their house and start talking about these things with a loud voice and the drama and the serpent and all these things. And the kids couldn't sleep at night from the nightmares because they really believe this stuff is going to happen.
فكرت ان انا برضو خلاص انا بدأت I'm starting to lose my God in Islam. Allah خلاص مش مصدقه مش مصدق ان في اله بهذه الطريقة مكرهني في حياتي. No personal relationship with him. ما فيش إني رزباني لما بصلي ما فيش حاجة بتدخل لي. إيه أصلي وبعدين إيه اللي حسيته؟
What started happening is I started losing my faith in this God. First of all, there's no personal relationship, and then he wants to do all this stuff to us. He wants to torment me like this, and there was no relationship, nothing. I wasn't getting nothing from him. I was losing my faith in this God.
Yeah. أظن سنة 91 سنة 1991 كان ظهور العذراء في أسيوط وفي عملت دوشة عملت خلت المسلمين كل الله إيه ده ده في شيء العذراء بتظهر.
In 1991 there was like an apparition of Mary that happened in Egypt and this really shocked a lot of the
Muslims. Yeah. وانا قعدت اسال اقول طب ليه عائشه ما تظهرش، ليه خديجه ما تظهرش، ليه محمد ما يظهرش.
And what I was thinking is why didn't Aisha appear or why didn't Khadija appear or why didn't Muhammad appear, why is it always the people the Christians believe in,
عموما انا خرجت الى طبعا جاتني سفريه ان انا اروح ادرس في السعودية فقلت دي فرصة ألحق إلهي قبل ما أفقده.
Then there came an opportunity for me to go teach Islam in Saudi Arabia. And I thought, well, maybe this is an opportunity for me to go try to regain my faith in this God before I totally lose him.
اتصدمت لأن أنا المفروض بدرس للدراسات العليا.
And I was shocked because this was supposed to be some very high level education.
اللي هو في الماجستير والدكتوراه بس يعني خمس ست طالبات.
Just there was only like five or six students because this was all masters and doctorate level classes.
وهذا النوع من الدراسة ال high studies. محتاجة face to face تتكلم معه وتتناقش.
Uh-huh. And these types of studies are so high level that they require face-to-face discussions, not just like in a big class session.
حطوني في بتاع زي السجن كده أكلم نفسي ها زي ستيشن كده صغيرة أكلم نفسي وهم يشوفوني وأنا ما أشوفهمش.
Okay. أقول لهم
طب ليه؟ قال لك قال عنده إغراء. طب ما أنا مش بغريهم برضو. الله
They said they put him in this little room. It's like he said it's like almost like a prison cell to talk to these students, and they would see him, but he can't see them. And he asked them, why are you doing this? And they said, so that there not be any kind of lust or temptation between you and them. And he says, wait a minute. So, you know, I might lust for them or desire them, but they won't desire me. It's like, he says, it doesn't make sense.
ما فيش المخ الواحد يفقد مخه. ما طبعا ما
When somebody loses their brain, it just makes no sense.
كتر خيرهم يعني حاجة مش ممكن. كانت نوع من العذاب ليا طبعا تعليم كلية الأدب لتعليم البنات في الرياض كانت
في واحد مسلم إسلام ديفندر يحيى هو بيضحك عليك بيقول هو بحكيش إنجليزي هذا واحد
I can speak English Mr. يحيى I like you ولا يهم
أنت بتعرفه؟
لا أنا بس عشان
هذا مشهور بيطلع دائما بيحكي
لا انا بس عشان انا اقدم عشان احنا الاثنين نقدم الشهاده بالعربي وبالانجليزي عشان العرب يفهمونا والانجليزي يفهموا السيد ستيف الانجليزي الامريكي
He says that's why we're doing this in two languages so that the Arabs can understand and so that the Americans and the British Where yeah. you're living can understand, since you probably don't speak Arabic either.
كمان أنا في ال كل أسبوعين ثلاثة يعلم ربنا كل فلوسي صرفتها رايح الكعبة جاي من الكعبة رايح على المدينة المنورة أرجع من عند محمد ما فيش حاجة غير كده ما أنا جاي أنا مش محتاج فلوس أنا مرتبي كبير ومكانتي كبيرة في مصر أنا
I had lots of money so all I would do. As I would go to Mecca to go to the Hajj and then I come back and then I go back and do the Hajj again and then go to Mecca and do the Umrah small.
Yeah. لكن أنا كنت فاهم إن أنا بحاول أسترد إيماني أسترد إسلامي.
I was trying to restore my Islam, restore my faith in my Islam.
Yes. لكن يبدو إن أنا دفنته في رمال صحراء السعودية قبل أن أعود وأعلن إني خلاص تركت الإسلام totally yeah. خلاص
It appears that what happened is that I completely buried my Islam in the sands of the deserts of Saudi Arabia and this is before I went back to Egypt to declare that I had left Islam
رجعت بعد 3 سنوات وكان العقد 6 سنوات لكن ما كملته.
Okay, I was supposed to be in Saudi Arabia for 6 years, but I just after 3 years I left the contract I took off and I went back to Egypt.
في Egypt بدأت المعركة الكبرى.
In Egypt the great battle began.
Because أنا ما أقدرش أعيش بدون إله.
Because I could not live without a god.
كل إنسان شرقي بالذات جسمه ما ينسجمش إلا مع فكرة الإله.
The every Eastern Middle Eastern person cannot exist without some concept of God in his life.
In his body كمان.
In his body also.
زي التايه طب أعمل إيه؟
I was like, I was lost. What can I do?
يعني صديقي المسيحي كان ضابط كبير وكنت أركب سيارته أجد شرايط للبابا شنودة بصوته الرخيم الجميل.
My friend was a Christian who was a very high level, like a lieutenant in the army. And I would ride in his car. He was a Christian. And sometimes I would hear, he would play tapes of Father Shinoda, Ababa Shinoda, who is the Pope, Coptic Pope, and he would be speaking about Jesus Christ and about the Lord.
Yeah. أو أسمع عنده ترانيم.
Or I would hear some of the worship music.
Yeah, زي حسين اللي بيعملها حسين.
Like Finn does. You guys, you gotta buy my tapes. Make me rich, people. Go on Amazon, buy my CDs, make me rich.
بس ما سمعتكش أنا هنا في مصر ما سمعتكش.
Even though he hasn't heard me in a long time, so.
وبعدين لقيت نفسي الله دي حاجة حلوة طعمها حلو في حاجة مختلفة في نور في جمال اللي محتاج له.
When I started hearing what the Christians and their sermons and their music and their worship, I said, oh, there's something sweet here. There's something beautiful here. This is what my spirit has been longing for.
لكن المشكلة إن ده كان عامل زي الضوء اللي في نهاية النفق.
But it was like a tiny light at the end of a long dark tunnel.
Yes. لكن ما أقدرش. ذقت الحلاوة فبدأت أسأل.
I tasted the sweetness and so I started asking questions.
كنت وأنا في شغلي أشرب قهوة كتير جدا لدرجة أحيانا ممكن يغمى عليا من كتر القهوة وما باكلش.
Okay. When I was I had been at my job, I'd be so busy, I would drink so much coffee. I was so addicted to coffee. I drank so much coffee to the point that I didn't eat.
مدير مكتبي قال لي تعالى اوديك عند ابونا يصلي لك.
And then there was somebody boss مدير
no my secretary my assistant
secretary.
Yeah.
Okay. His secretary or his assistant said to him once, says, come here, I want to take you to the Christian priest so that he could pray for you.
I refused, طبعا في البداية, لكن رحت مضطر, أنا محتاج أشوف حاجة حلوة. رحت معاه, رحنا في سيارته.
At first I rejected, but then I needed something. So I went with him, I went in the car.
وأنا فاكر أن أنا أشوف حد كبير كده, شخصية كبيرة في المسيحية.
Then I saw somebody who was big, who was important in the Christian community.
لكن طلع فراش الكنيسة.
But he was just the painter.
Housekeeper الكنيسة.
Yeah, the cleaner, the janitor. Yeah,
of the yeah. أنا مسكت الموظف بالعد وبهدلته. أنت بتجيبني عندي واحد أنا قال لي لا ده بركة. لازم استنى wait. He's the blessing demand.
I got angry at my assistant who took me there. I said, why are you bringing me here? And then, but then he says, just wait, be patient.
وفعلا هو حط ايده هنا. Started to pray for me. لقيت دموعي بتنزل وجسمي كده يهتز.
The priest, the father put his hand on his
مش father ولا priest, فراش.
الفراش.
Just worker.
The
worker, nor man, a person, a Christian person.
Okay, so it wasn't the priest. It was just the janitor, the guy that works at the church there. This simple guy just put his hand on his head and began to pray for him, for Dr. Muhammad, and the tears began to fall from
him. Shaking.
He was shaking in his body.
الصلاة جميلة.
It was such a beautiful prayer.
أول مرة أتلمس وأحس بحاجة حلوة.
The first time I ever felt something beautiful like that.
رجعت فرحان.
I went home so happy.
بس still, أنا عايز more and more.
But I wanted more.
وبرضو الكتاب المقدس عندي في البيت على مكتبي.
And I had the Bible in my house on my desk.
أنا كأكاديمي لازم يكون عندي كتاب المقدس.
You know, because I was an academic, I had the Bible. Not because I believed, but because I was an academic.
ودرست عبري.
And I also studied Hebrew. I studied, the original language of the Bible.
لكن ما مش عارف أفتح الكتاب.
But I
cannot open the book and
I didn't know how to open the Bible. I didn't know how to what to do, where to go.
حاجة مسكاني.
But خايف. Grab. It was, I was afraid.
I am scared for my Islamic to gun to be gun.
I feared that I would lose my Islam if I read this book.
كنت في حرب.
I was in a war.
Yeah, big conflict. في هنا عندهم في النور شوية بحثاً عن يسوع وفي الظلمة شوية خايف أفقد الإسلام تماماً.
I had a little bit of light when I'd be looking for Jesus and drawing close to him, and then the darkness of when my fear of losing my Islam.
Yeah. وانتهى هذا الصراع بصوت جوايا.
And this
inside me.
This battle ended when I heard a voice inside of me.
Come to America, you will see me. تعال أمريكا سوف تراني.
And I heard the voice say, come to America and you will see me.
أنا كنت جيت أمريكا سنة 92 تقريبا قبل ما أروح السعودية.
I came to America in 1992 before I went to Saudi Arabia.
كان اسمها professor visiting.
It was like an academic visitation by a professor.
Yeah, لكن ما حبيتش أمريكا. I don't like it.
بس أنا ما حبيتش أمريكا. I mean, I didn't like America. لكن إنجليزي.
لكن
عربي.
لكن مش عارف أنا. المهم أجي أمريكا ريم أنا ما حبيتهاش.
I came to America, but I didn't like it.
جيت بعد ما ضغطت على رئيس الجامعة زهيد في my university. I have to come. I have to take the permission to come.
Okay. خليك بالعربي.
سألت رئيس الجامعة اديني أجازة. قال لي الأجازة خلصت. أنت في نص أغسطس. في نص أغسطس. الأجازة بتبدأ من أول يوليو. أنت شهر ونص راح. كنت فين؟ جاي تاخد أجازة الآن.
So at about the middle of August, he went and asked the professor the chief of the at the university, his boss, say, "Hey, I need to take my break because I want to go to America." He says, "Well, your break begins in June. It's almost the end of August now."
المهم بعد نقاش لأنه كان صديقي اداني الأجازة.
After a little bit of discussion, he allowed me to go.
وخدت الفيزا طبعاً. الناس تقول لك. هو أصلي تنصر عشان يدخل أمريكا. يا عبيط يا ابني يا عبيط.
People started saying, which they always do, he became a Christian so that he can go to America. He just wants to go to America.
أنا ما بروحش أجيب الفيزا. أنا ببعت موظف من عندي يروح السفارة يقول لهم الدكتور رحومة عايز فيزا. خد اتفضل.
I had one of my employees go to the consulate and say, get the visa for me. And he would just say, Dr. Rahuma wants a visa. And they just stamped on it and give it to me immediately.
عشان مخهم اللي ما فيهوش حاجة غير أمريكا. أصلا عايز أروح أمريكا. أروح أمريكا ليه؟ أنا ما أحب.
Their brain is like that. They think, oh, everybody just, you know, they're liars. They claim to be Christian just because they want to go to America. That's all that they have in their brain. I went to America. I didn't like it.
ترك الإسلام عشان يروح أمريكا. المهم.
He left Islam so that he can go to America.
جيت في 19 أغسطس.
I came on August 2001.
وفضلت. فين ربنا؟ فين ربنا؟ مفيش.
I said, where's the Lord? Where's the Lord? I don't see anything.
أنا مش شايف حاجة. بعد كده قلت الله الأجازة خلصت خلاص. أنا واخد أسبوعين أجازة. Only two weeks only.
I only had a two-week vacation. It was almost over. I didn't see nothing. I didn't find God or anything.
رحت بقى قلت خلاص ده مفيش فايدة. أروح أعمل التذكرة. كرحت أعمل التذكرة الرجوع لأن كانت التيكت أوبن.
Okay.
Going back to Egypt كان أوبن. فرحت أأكد الحجز الرجوع لإيجيبت.
أوكي روحت عملت I mean I went to make the reserve my seat to come back to Egypt because I was already my vacation was over already and my ticket was open. I could have stayed as long as I want to, but I made my reservation to come back to Egypt.
كان اليوم ده الاثنين يوم الاثنين 10 سبتمبر 2001. خدوا بس عشان تعرف التواريخ.
This day the day that I did this was September 10th 2001.
عملت التذكرة ورجعت زعلان بقى من ربنا بقى ده ايا كان انا ما اعرفش هو مين.
I had the ticket ready and I was angry at the Lord because I felt disappointed.
كان مفروض تذكرتي يوم الخميس الساعة 7 مساء. دي تذكرتي يوم الخميس 13 سبتمبر ارجع.
I was supposed to return on the Thursday, which was September 13th at 7 o'clock at night to Egypt. That was my flight, is to come back to Egypt on the 13th of September.
بس عاتبته وإذا كنت زعلان ما أعرفش من هو بس كلمته.
I was angry at God, but I spoke to him.
ليه بتعمل؟ طب عايز مني إيه؟ What do you need? ماذا تريد مني؟ ماذا تريد؟
I asked him, what do you want from me? Why are you doing this to me?
ونمت بدري.
And I went to bed early that night.
والصبح أختي بتصحيني، كنت عند أختي في ذلك الوقت.
I was at my staying at my sister's house and my sister woke me up early the next morning.
الحق الدنيا خربت في أمريكا.
She says, hurry, get up. The world is falling apart in America.
Yeah, أنا افتكرت أنت عارف في أمريكا شوية أمطار تقيلة أقول لك emergency، شوية عواصف أقول لك emergency، فأنا قلت شوية emergency من بتوعتهم ونمت برضه.
And I thought, oh, another American emergency. Whenever there's a little bit of rain, they say it's an emergency. When there's a little bit of snow, they say it's an emergency. Whenever there's a storm, they say it's an emergency. I said, another one of America's emergencies. So I just put my head back and fell asleep again.
لكن المشكلة إن أختي قالت لي قوم ده الحرب هتقوم.
But my sister said to me, get up. A war is going to start.
قمت.
I got up. I said, what happened?
لقيت التلفزيون بيزيع سبتمبر 11 بيزيع المباني بتقع بشكل زي ما تكون بسكوتة وبتنتهي كده منظر لا يمكن انساه.
What I saw on television of course on September 11th was the Twin Towers. I watched as the buildings collapsed as if they were like you know made of like a gingerbread house just collapsing. It's sights that I'll never forget for the rest of my life.
انا هيدا فعلا. وبعدين المؤلم عندي ان فتحت القنوات العربية وجدتهم بيوزعوا شوكولاتة وشربات في الشوارع.
And then what really broke my heart is I saw some of the Arabic stations talking about this and there were people out in the streets handing out candy and congratulating one another because of the attack that had happened in America.
هلا هيدا احنا وحشين لهذه الدرجة.
And I thought, are we really this barbaric? Are we Arabs really this barbaric?
وتألمت قلت ما هم. وبعدين بدأوا بعد أيام بعد تاني يوم تقريبا بدأوا يزيعوا ناس من اللي عملوا الحادثة.
And then they began rescuing people from what had happened.
وبدأوا يدور على كل واحد اسمه محمد وانا اسمي محمد.
And they started looking for every person named Mohammed and my name is Mohammed.
وبالعكس ده انا مش محمد وبس. ده انا اللي عملت المحمدون كلهم الشيوخ.
I'm not just Mohammed, I'm the one who made all the other Mohammeds.
وهم لو قلت اني انا كنت بخرج من تحت ايدي الشيوخ والائمه كانوا مسكوني.
If they knew that I was the one who was teaching all these guys, I'm the one who graduated all of these imams and all these sheikhs, they would have captured me and imprisoned me.
انا كل ما اخدم في كنيسه امريكيه اقول لهم كده يتجنن من الضحك.
Whenever I minister in an American church, I tell them this, and they just burst out laughing.
ويقولوا لي finally مسكنا الارهاب الكبير.
They say finally we caught the biggest terrorist of all.
لكن فعلا ربنا يسمع دم. اوعى تحتقر ده الدرس اللي خدته. اوعى تحتقر نفسك، انت غالي عليه. لو ما فيش غيرك انت بس على وجه الارض، هيجي يسوع لاجلك ويعمل الخلاص لاجلك ويحط نفسه على الصليب لاجلك. اوعى تفتكر انك مش غالي عليه، انت غالي 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 قوي قوي.
Don't ever think, don't ever lessen your value to God. You are so valuable to God. He loves you so much. If you were the only person who ever lived, Jesus Christ would have left heaven and come to earth to die for you on the cross to save you from going to hell. Don't ever devalue yourself. I knew how precious I was to him. I said, Lord, you'll tear the whole world apart for me.
ما انا لو كنت رجعت مصر كان خلاص الموضوع انتهى بالنسبه لي.
If I had gone back to Egypt at that time,
it's done.
The situation would have ended. It would have been over for me at that point.
لكن هو وقفني وكل الرحلات الطيران اتكنسلت والدنيا وقفت لمده يمكن اسبوعين او ثلاثه.
And at that time all of the flights were canceled for more than 2 weeks. All of the flights were canceled. To where nobody could go or come.
وطبعا في وسط هذا الجو كان جو روحي. روحي yes, spiritual environment وتراجيدي. ها؟ روحي وتراجيدي. عمل لي حاجة زي ما أكون أنا ماشي بريموت كنترول. حد ماسك الريموت وبيمشيني. ها؟ تعال روح تعال روح.
And it was like that in that atmosphere of tragedy, there was a great spiritual experience as well. And I felt like I was under remote control. Somebody would say, go there, do this, do that. I said, God wants me to hear his voice. I saw him in this situation.
Big difference, ya Hussein. اني انا اسمع عن سبتمبر 11 وانا في مصر او اعيش سبتمبر 11 في امريكا.
It's a huge difference. Had I heard about September 11th in Egypt versus having experienced it here in the United States.
كان جو ما انا حتى الان كل ما افتكره مش مصدق ان ربنا يكلمني بالمصائب بالأحداث، يغلق المطارات عشاني، يقول لي أنا موجود، يقول لي أنت غالي عليا، يقول لي أنا مش قلت لك هتشوفني في أمريكا، أنا كذبت عليك.
And so it's like even today when I think about it, I can't, it makes me cry that God brought me here and through these events God spoke to me and made me aware of how precious I am to him and how much he loves me and how real he is.
مش ناسي الأحداث أبداً. المهم
يوم these events.
يوم الأربع عدى يوم الثلاث السيء، يوم الثلاثاء الأسود، لكنه كان أبيض بالنسبة لي.
Even though it was a black, it was called Black Tuesday the day after, and then Black Wednesday the day after. But for me, it was a white day.
يوم الأربع
On Wednesday.
على الكافي تيبل عند اختي اللي هو البتاع ده اللي هو دليل التليفونات العربي.
دليل
بوك فون بالعربي بوك فون بتاع زي الاستعلامات كده.
A phone book. Okay. I went and saw the phone book in my sister's house on the table.
Yeah, وفتحت ده بالعربي. فتحت
in Arabic.
كنائس عربية. ولقيت نفسي بكتب أرقام الكنائس
Arabic churches and I wrote down the names of the Arabic churches
the numbers phone number.
The phone numbers of the Arabic churches.
وكانت الساعة واحدة الظهر وخرجت أتكلم، ما أقدرش أتكلم من عند أختي. خرجت ما كانش في there is no mobile like now.
We didn't used to have mobile phones back then, so you know I had to go out. I couldn't speak from my sister's house because she's Muslim, so I had to go outside the house in order to speak to some of these churches.
واتصلت لقيت لقيت فويس ميل قلت خلاص بقى ما
if I heard somebody's voicemail I just ignored him.
رجعت البيت تاني لكن فضل معايا رقم تاني كان 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 رقم قس من ميريلاند انت تعرفه يا حسين اللي هو باستر موسى جوزيف موسى.
But then I found the pastor, there was an Arabic pastor in Maryland.
Yeah. كلمته في التليفون طبعا كنت بتكلم من من برجر البلازا كان فيها برجر كينج وبعض المحلات الصغيره
سمول بلازا. I was talking to him from a mall that was near Burger King on the phone.
وانا كلمته بقول له انا فلان انا اسمي محمد كان المفروض يسمع كلمه محمد يدب التليفون.
I told him I'm so and so my name is Mohammed. You know it should have been that when he heard the name Mohammed he just closed the phone in my face.
يعني قلت له أنا دكتور وعميد كلية إسلامية وبدور على
I'm a doctor and I'm the dean of a college in Egypt.
وأنا بدور على إله حقيقي أنا مش جاي أمريكا عشان أقعد أنا عندي البيج بوزيشن عندي أنا راجع تاني بس عايز أعرف مين هو الإله الحقيقي.
But I came to America. I didn't come here just to be in America. I'm looking for the living God. You know, and I want the true God, and I don't want to go back. I want to know who is this true God.
أنا خفت أقول له أنا السبب في سبتمبر 11 يمسكوه ويمسكوني.
I didn't want to tell him, you know, I'm the cause of September 11th because they would arrest him and arrest me too.
لكن هو ابتدى يتكلم وقال لي أول كلمة طلعت منه أهلا حبيبي. Welcome حبيبي.
The first thing he said to me was, "Welcome, Habibi, my friend."
Habibi is magic word. كلمة حلوة تفتح القلب كده. إحنا في الإسلام محرومين من الحب. لا نمارس الحب ولا نتعاطى بالحب.
Yes.
The
word Habibi, you know, comes from the word حب, which means love. And so we don't have love in Islam. There is no love, you know, with God. God is not love. And so just to hear that word, just it opens your heart.
لما يقول لي اهلا beloved one يعني حاجه تسعدني تفرح قلبي.
It was something that makes your heart happy.
Yeah, فروحت طبعا قلت له انا عايز اعرف الاله الحقيقي مين هو.
I said I want to know who the true God is.
Who? قال لي يسوع. قلت له يسوع. يسوع اللي هو عيسى عندنا في القران. لا ما اسموش عيسى الاسم الحقيقي يسوع.
And I said, oh yeah, Jesus, he's Isa in the Quran. But he says, no, he's not Isa, he's Jesus.
قلت له ازاي يعني؟ طب انا عملت مش انا يعني هيقبلني ازاي؟ ده انا عامل بلاوي، ده انا عامل مشاكل كتير، انا
خلاص
عقول.
How could he help me with all of the problems that I've made and all the sins that I've committed, you know?
قال لي ده هو حبيب الخطاة.
And he told me that Jesus is the friend of sinners.
الله الله يعني مش ماسك الكرباج ولا العصاية ولا نكر ونكر وبيخبط فيا يقول لي ما تغلطش ما تعملش غلط يا محمد عم غلط يا محمد غلط ما فيش حبيب الخطاة الله.
You mean and Dr. Muhammad said to the pastor, he said, you mean he's not holding the whip so that he could whip me and then the stick so he could beat me on the head with it or those silver hammers of Nakir and Makir that are going to hit me when after I'm dying? He's not going to do that to me? He said he's a friend of sinners.
Allah. يعني في حد بيحبني وانا وحش.
And I thought, you mean somebody loves me when I'm so evil?
الأسيس قال لي أنا كنت أسوأ منك.
And the pastor said, I was worse than you.
وحبيته وجالي وغير حياتي.
And he loved me, came to me, and changed my life.
قلت له طب ازاي انا اقبله ويغير حياتي وابقى مسيحي؟
And I said, how can I accept him and he changed my life and become a Christian?
قال لي صلي معايا. قلت له صلي ازاي في الشارع؟ اي من زي انا اصلي يا عم؟ انا فاكر ان انا هعمل زي الاسلام. الله اكبر.
When he said pray with me, I thought that I had to do the prayer, you know, the Muslim prayer, to get out the prayer rug.
قال لي لا قول ورايا قول ورايا.
No, he said no, just say these words with me.
طبعا انا في هذه الحاله بدات اتردد.
I started hesitating a little.
اقشعر هيضحك عليك. السيس يضحك عليك.
Maybe استنى. He's mocking you or deceiving you.
وبينما انا اصارع الشيطان اللي مانعني ان انا اصلي معاه، لقيت يسوع بيظهر من خلال الستاند بتاع التليفون ده اللي في الشارع. لقيته wow. بيعمل لي كده.
While I was hesitating, while Satan was trying to keep me from praying, I saw Jesus appearing around the telephone stand.
وكان بيعمل لي كده.
And he was doing this with his head.
الأسيس يصلي وأنا شايف اللبس بتاعت يسوع هي اللي بتتحرك، كأنه هو اللي بيتكلم بلسان الأسيس.
I could hear the pastor speaking, but I saw the Jesus. I was looking at Jesus, and his lips were moving as if the pastor was speaking Jesus's words.
طبعا قلت له ايوه يا رب انا بقبلك، ايوه يا رب انا بقبلك، انا بحبك يا رب، انا عايزك يا رب.
And I said, Lord, I accept you. Lord, I desire you. I accept you, my Lord.
وصارت قشعريرة جوه جسمي. فعلا ماء انهار حيه دخلت جسمي وراوتني وغيرتني تماما في لحظه. فعلا
the spirit, the Holy Spirit, the living water exploding inside of me. I mean, truly, I felt myself, I had come to life.
وبدأت اعيط.
And I started crying.
بصوت عالي اقول يا رب انا ما استاهلش يا رب توريني نفسك وتعرفني نفسك وتجيبني ليك. ما استاهلش انا يا رب انا ومش قادر. وبعدين عمال احط وشي جوه البوكس بتاع التليفون عشان الناس وهي ماشيه ما تشوفنيش وانا بعيط. كنت بعيط بصوت عالي، ببكي بصوت عالي. قلت الناس يقولوا ده مجنون ولا ماله ده.
I was crying with a loud voice there by the telephone, and people are walking by, and I'm thinking the people all think that I'm insane crying so loud out here.
وروحت البيت عند اختي وانا طفل. فعلا ولدت الان.
I went to my sister's house and I was like a brand new baby. I was just born.
بس ماسك يسوع كده في ايديا.
But I held Jesus in my hand.
وماشي بيه. انا خايف امسك ايدي يجري مني. ماشي.
I'm afraid that if I let go of him that he would run away.
يسيبني.
That he would leave.
ورحت نمت. كانت الساعة 7 مساء.
It was only like 7 o'clock at night, but I went and slept.
وقت تقول لي انت هتنام دلوقتي، قلت لها انا عايز مكان وحدية بي، انا عايز انفرد بي، انا مع العريس، انا عايز اكون معاه الليلة كله، مش هسيبك.
You know, and my sister said, you're going to go to sleep now. And I said, no, I just need a place to be with him. I want to be with the bridegroom. I want to just be alone with him.
انا بكلم نفسي ما اقدرش اقول لها الكلام ده هتذبحني.
Of course I couldn't tell her this because she would kill me, but I was saying this to myself.
وفعلا دخلت كده ورحت حطيت ملايه على وشي عشان اعمل نوع من البرايفت ليا عشان
So I went the sheet on my head so that I kind of just be closed off by myself.
وفضلت معاه اتكلم معاه واقول له انت اخرت عليا وانا سني 47 سنه دلوقتي، ليه ما جتنيش من زمان؟ ليه تسيبني؟
And I started saying to him, why did you wait so long to come to me? I've been alive for 47 years. Why did you wait until now to finally come to me?
وفضلت معاه لغايه الصبح.
And I was talking to him until the morning.
وبعدين شفت رؤية مش حلم. It is not a dream.
Then I had a vision.
Vision.
It was not a good dream.
أنا بغرق في البحر وجي البوليس طلع الجثة بتاعتي.
That I was drowning in the sea and the police came and pulled out my corpse.
Yeah. وبعدين قال لي أنت أهو. This is your ID. دي بطاقتك اهو محمد محمود رحومه.
And then he took the ID out and he says, is this you? This is your ID, محمد رحومه.
قلت له انا عايش اهو.
I'm here.
وانا برضو معايا بطاقتي اهي. محمد محمود رحومه.
And I showed him my ID. I said, I am محمد رحومه.
قال له امال مين ده؟
And they said, well, then who's this? This dead person.
I told them, انا ما اعرفوش.
I said, I don't know him.
ده old محمد, محمد القديم.
This is the old Muhammad.
انا ما اعرفوش.
I don't know him.
انا ما قريتش. I never read about bird again ولا بورصه again. Never. انا ما قريتش قبل كده عن الولاده الجديده ولا ما never ولا سمعت.
Before this, I had never heard about being born again. I never heard anything about it. I never knew anything about being born again. But this was like this dream was explained, this vision.
قريت على القسيس الصبح.
I went to the pastor in the morning.
I told him the vision. I قلت له الرؤية.
I told him the vision I had.
قال لي مبروك. يسوع.
Congratulations. Jesus baptized you.
Yeah, Jesus عمدك بنفسه. مبروك. وانت بقى هترجع.
Into Jesus Christ. Jesus baptized you into himself.
ايه خطتك؟ قلت له هرجع مصر طبعا. قال لي طب اشوفك اليوم. I told him I will هرجع مصر. لازم هرجع مصر. ما اقدرش اقعد هنا. اقعد اعمل ايه؟ في المساء نفس ميعاد الطيارة جاني ومعاه شوية كتب مسيحية وفيهم الكتاب المقدس.
And as I was going to, because I was going to go back to Egypt, he brought me a box of a bunch of books. Among them was the Bible.
بعدين قال لي ده خدت الكتب طبعا جعان. الكتاب المقدس بالعهد القديم بالعهد الجديد فريته في 3 ايام قاعد ما بعملش قريته في 3 ايام.
I was so hungry. I read the whole Bible, Old and New Testament in 3 days.
وفعلا حلاوة وكله مشتهيات.
And it was so sweet and the taste was so full of glory.
ما صدقتش الحلاوة.
I couldn't believe the sweetness.
الله ده احنا كنا مظلومين. ده احنا بنقرا قران عن البقره وعن الكلب وعن البرغوت وعن الحمار وحواديت
we were reading the Quran about the cow and about the donkey and about the bugs
والنمله
and the ants.
لكن ما تقرا حاجات حلوه كده.
But in the Bible you read these beautiful things.
تحس انك بتشوف يسوع وبتلمس يسوع.
You're seeing Jesus, like you're touching Jesus.
بصوا حلاوة لا يمكن أي مسلم يتصورها.
It's a sweetness that no Muslim can even imagine.
أو يتخيلها. مستحيل. مستحيل. طبعا القصة عشان طويلة. يا احنا قاعدين ساعة. القصة عشان طويلة. طبعا رجعت بعد كده. أنا ككاتب I am a writer بحب أكتب.
And I'm a writer so I wrote.
عندي الجورنال بتاعي أكتب فيه اللي حصل وبتاع فكتبت قصتي أنا لسه محتفظ بها لغاية الآن.
I wrote my story and I still have it.
Yeah. أنا وسبتها على الترابيزة اللي قاعد فيها على الترابيزة السفرة كده فأختي صدفة يعني فتحت وقالت أنا أخويا بيه مسيحي يا لهوتي أختي my sister. المهم بلغت الدنيا.
Anyway, he had the
my journal.
He had written his testimony and then he had put it on the sofa and he just kind of left it there and then his sister read it and then she started going crazy. What? My brother became Christian and then she went and started telling people.
وكلمت الناس المسؤولين اللي في مصر الحقوه هي هيجيب لنا العار خدوا بالكم.
He told the people in Egypt.
أول ما يوصل يا تقتلوه
يا
ترجعوه. المهم مشيت طبعا على 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 مصر يوم كان يوم أظن كان يوم 15 أكتوبر بعد ما اتفتحت المطارات والدنيا شوية راقت.
It was around October 15th after the airports started
في
open.
في مصر عشت هم أسبوعين.
I lived 2 weeks in Egypt.
طبعاً كنت معرض للقتل والدنيا خربانة وقصتي طلع في كل حتة ما عرفش إيه اللي حصل والناس عرفت.
My story, the story about me had gone all over Egypt.
واللي عايز يلحق ال 72 حرية بقتله لمحمد المرتد.
And they were كيف كان يقولوا؟
اللي عايز يلحق ال 72 حرية مع بقتلي هو جاعد هو بقي شهيد.
What they were saying to the people was whoever wants to get his 72 virgins up in El Jannah, you'll get it by killing Madrahuma, who is a captive.
المهم طبعا بعد اسبوعين ربنا خلق لي طريق جديد ان انا ارجع تاني. رجعت هنا في 4 نوفمبر والجامعه اللي جابتني قالت لي اتفضل امشي من هنا.
اوكي
عملوا لي لايك كونفرنس في امريكا. يعني ما فيش حد يطلع وسط العام الدراسي.
ايوه
وقت الدراسه ما يقدرش يطلع. فعملوا لي ان انت عندك كونفرنس في امريكا لمده 3 ايام اطلع على امريكا يلا.
And so the university actually helped him. They made him an invitation to go see an educational conference in America and he actually was able to come back to America 2 weeks later on November 4th.
Yeah, طبعا كان في شخصية كبيرة دايما احكي عنها انها وقفت معايا لان الباسبور كانت خدته المخابرات مني. My passport. انا عندي باسبور دبلوماسي.
Yeah, he had a diplomatic passport but the secret police took it away from him. But there was a woman who helped him a lot.
شخصية كبيرة هي
very
مرت حسني مبارك زوجة حسني مبارك.
Yeah. The wife of حسني مبارك.
Yeah,
the Mubarak helped get him.
Yeah,
wow. Suzanne.
وهي على فكرة مسيحية.
Yeah, and she's Christian, by the way.
Yeah, بس under نيس زي لينا كده. إحنا مش under نيس دلوقتي. إحنا فوق النيس ونص.
Yeah. Thank God for her.
جيت أمريكا.
I came to America.
وبدأت المعاناة.
And I started suffering.
والكنائس تخاف. أوه ده مين ده 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 كان عميد كلية يا عم ده 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 مخابرات ده جاي.
Were afraid of me.
ده جاي يجمع أسماء النصارى أو المسيحيين اللي هم ضد حاجات غريبة. المهم طبعا يعني شفت أيام صعبة جدا. اشتغلت في جامعات كتيرة، اشتغلت في يو اس نيفل اكاديمي، واشتغلت في ميريلاند يونيفرستي، واشتغلت في ستيت ديبارتمنت مع وزارة الخارجية.
خلينا نترجم بس. I started working for US Naval Academy. I started working for university in Maryland and I started doing all different kinds of jobs. And you know, like I said, the churches were scared, especially the Arabic churches were scared of me because they were suspicious that I was coming there to get the names of all the Christians to report it to the secret police in Egypt. And believe me, guys, there is this fear. And there are people who do that. And so he was underneath all this pressure, man.
لكن طبعا شفت رؤية تانية.
But then I saw another vision.
وسمعت صوته بيقول لي.
And I heard a voice telling me.
إذ الضرورة موضوعة علي. إذ الضرورة موضوعة علي. ده فالويل لي إن لم أبشر. بس الزبرز.
I felt the thing that is important for me is woe is me if I do not preach the gospel.
Yeah. الآية اللي قبلها هي الآية اللي قالها لي 3 مرات.
He told me 3 times the verse that
is الضرورة موضوعة علي. Is الضرورة موضوعة علي. أنا الجزء ده من الفيرز من الآية دي مخفي يعني اللي مشهور فالويل لي إن لم أبشر. إنما الفيرز ده النص الأول من الآية ما حدش كتير يعرفه. إذ الضرورة موضوع أي ضرورة إيه يعني طبعا.
Okay. خليني بس أحكيها. He says the part that was he heard repeated 3 times was for if I preach the gospel I have nothing to glory of for necessity is laid upon me.
Me.
Necessity is laid upon me. necessity is laid upon me. For woe unto me if I preach not the gospel.
Amen. طبعا سبت الجامعات وسبت العمل. آخر وظيفة كانت في State Department في وزارة الخارجية الأمريكية. في
I left all of the work with the government and the universities. I worked, my last job was with the U.S. State Department.
وبدأت بقى أشتغل في الخدمة. قابلت في ذلك الوقت حسين وأنشأ.
That's when me and him met. This was about in 2010. That's when I had been in the Middle East as an evangelist, and then I lived in Sweden for 3 years. And by the way, you guys, in a few days, I'm going to be doing something about Sweden, and it is devastating. So please make sure and be with me when I talk about it. So, but anyway, I met Dr. Rahoma when I was just come back from the mission trip after 13 years on the mission trip field. I came back here. I wanted to leave Orange County. I really wanted to leave Orange County. And the day I was going to leave Orange County, I got this terrible toothache. And because of the toothache, I had to stay, go to a dentist and do all that. And I didn't, then I forgot about leaving. And so, and it was a few weeks later, I met Dr. Muhammad, and he's the one who took me onto Arabic television. And then he introduced me to Father Zechariah. And so, you know, he was a source of many great blessings in my life.
Thank you so much. وعملنا برنامج عملنا اجتماع رائع للمتنصرين في الكنيسة استمر 6-7 سنوات.
Yeah, and we had a meeting in the Coptic Church in Orange County for ex-Muslims in Arab.
كانت الكنيسة أحيانا بتبقى مليانة فول.
Yeah,
كبيرة.
There were so many ex-Muslims.
وكان المرنم بتاعنا حسين.
And I was a singer, you guys. That's why you have to buy my record. You have to go to Amazon and buy my CD. Give me some rest.
وأنا في خدمتي الآن.
واو صدق.
عايز أتكلم عن خدمتنا. مش هما يعني المسلم السابق اللي بيقبل المسيح بيتعمد بصعوبة. يعني بيعمدوه بصعوبة. ولما
The person who is from a Muslim background, it's very difficult for them when they come to the Lord to be baptized.
Especially, أنا بتكلم على مصر.
Especially, I'm talking in Egypt.
Yeah. لكن طبعا بعد ما بيتعمد كمان ده إذا عمدوه. ما فيش حد بيسمع عنه يقولوا له ما تجيش الكنيسة تاني. ما تعمل لناش مشاكل. Don't come here again.
Quite often in the Middle East, this is a very real situation that somebody who's Muslim, who gets saved, gets born again, gets baptized, quite often the churches will tell them, okay, please don't come back because it's going to cause us problems because the secret police are watching.
وطبعا أنا خدمتي الآن بهتم غير البرامج اللي بعملها غير التبشير غير وأقوى أنواع الكرازة هي الكرازة بالاختبار الكرازة بالشهادة الكرازة بالتستموني بتاعك لأن مش ما حدش يقدر ينكر شهادتك يعني
the strongest form of evangelism that we have is to share your testimony because you know it says in the Bible so they overcame Satan by the word of their testimony and the blood of Christ. So it's the strongest form of evangelization that we have is sharing your testimony.
وأنا برضو عايز أقول إن بولس الرسول بدأ خدمته وبشارته ونشر إنجيل المسيح بالتستموني بتاعه.
And the Apostle Paul started his ministry, his preaching with his own testimony.
لما قال اختباره عرفوه تعالى انت مننا وبدأ
كرازة. When they shared his testimony they knew they said hey, you're one of us.
لذلك انا بكلم كل متنصر
every single ex-Muslim
موجود برا بلده
who is not in his own country right now
اطلع واتكلم
come on and talk share your testimony
كل شهادة كل كلمة منك هتهدم أسوار في الإسلام وهتجيب ناس كتير حتى من المسيحيين الإسميين هتقوي إيمانهم.
Every word you speak is going to break down the walls to keep the Muslims in their prison. It's going to break down barriers and open the way for more other Muslims to come to the Lord. And it's going to encourage the Christians who are not really born again Christian to come draw closer to the Lord and really come to know the Lord.
انت مش عارف شهادتك بتعمل ايه.
You don't know what your testimony can do.
شهادتك بتحطم جبال.
Your testimony destroys mountains. زي ناكر ومنكير الشكوش تبعهم.
وانا محتاج لك تيجي تشهد عشان نفسنا سوا خلاص ندفن الاسلام ندفنه. هو مات كلينيكيا خلاص راح انتهى صدقوني.
Yes.
عايش في الارجنت كير دي.
He says, come and share your testimony and together let's bury Islam. Islam is already dead. I mean, it's living in the urgent care right now. It's on life support. It's dying. Come on, let's bury it together.
تعال ايدك مين هيدفن مش احنا اصحاب القدام. تعال ندفنه سوا. تعال معايا ندفنه.
Come on, let's bury Islam together. Let's join hands together to bury Islam. Who's going to bury that corpse?
ونعلن مجد المسيح من جديد.
Declare the glory of Jesus Christ.
ونقول ونعرف الدنيا كلها ان في رسل المسيح الجدد المتنصرون.
The whole world know that there are the new apostles of Jesus Christ.
دول فعلا الكنيسة الأولى كنيسة سفر أعمال الرسل.
The church of the book of Acts.
مفيش ما حدش بيبشر غير الناس دي دلوقتي.
Right now, nobody else evangelizes except for these people right now. Nobody else is evangelizing.
اوعى تفتكر الوعظات العظيمة دي بتجيب ناس.
Don't think the great sermons that you're hearing brings people to the Lord Jesus.
ممكن تبلد الفيس تبني الإيمان.
Strengthen the faith and strengthen the believers.
لكن الشهادة والاختبار.
But it is the testimony, the living testimony of conversions. That's what brings people to Jesus.
هي اللي بتشهد ليك وهي اللي بتجيب الناس.
That's what draws people to the Lord.
وهي اللي بتخلخل الإسلام.
And that's what shakes the walls of Islam.
وتخليه ينتهي.
And let it come to an end.
هم عارفين إنه انتهى.
They know it's over. They know it's dead.
ولذلك هم بيشتدوا في ضربهم وصراعهم معنا وفي اضطهادهم لينا.
And that's why they are even more committed in their opposition and in their strong, you know, hits against us.
هم عارفين النهاية قربت.
They know the end is near.
ويسوع على الأبواب.
And Jesus is standing at the door.
وأنا أرجو منك إنك تفتح له الباب وتقول له تفضل.
I ask of you, open the door to Jesus and say, come in.
خليه يدخل حياتك.
Let him come into your life.
ويغيرها.
And change it.
وتقف معانا وتمجد اسمه وتعلن.
Us and glorify his name.
وتعلن مجد المسيح على كل الخليقة. يا
and
رب.
And declare the glory of Jesus for all of creation.
آمين.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. عظيم جدا. الناس في مسلمين تعرف بعد من هذول المسلمين هم هذول متشددين في لندن. في انجلترا. هذول في انجلترا وهناك ببشروا بطرق بشرة. لكن طلعوا اليوم عشانك.
عشان يسمعونا؟
مشان يسمعوك. وفي واحد بده يطلع. في واحد بيقول لي أنا بدي أطلع أحكي معكم. أقول أجيبه؟
أصل احنا مش لو أنت عارف لسانهم مش محترم.
صح.
وإحنا عايزين نحافظ على المشاهدين بتوعتنا كده رقيين ومحترمين. أوكي. انت عارف لسانه لا يصعفه من هيلجأ للبذاءات. ما انا بعيد عن كل هذه لان الكتاب بيقول اجتنبوا المجادلات الغبيه.
اوكي.
دي مجادلات غبيه ما تليقش بينا. هتسمعوا ايه؟ هو لو عايز يسوع جابني من مصر عشان اشوفه هنا في امريكا. هو لو عايز يسوع بيعجب نفسه عن حد. Yes. هو لو عايز انما يقعد يجادل معانا مجادلات ومحادث ما لا تليق بمجد الرب اللي احنا بنمجده ولا الناس اللي بتسمعك المحترمة.
خلينا ترجم بس عشان I was asking Dr. Muhammad, you know, there's somebody who said they want to come on, they want me to send an invitation, you know, one of the Muslims and stuff, and he says, you know, they're going to come on and they're going to start saying all these disgusting stuff and they're going to speak words that are not worthy of the glory of God. He says, if they want Jesus, Jesus brought me all the way from Egypt to America, you know, to show me himself and reveal himself to me. Jesus is right there. If they want him, they can find him. He's not far away. You know, they don't need to come on here and start speaking all these negative words and cussing and everything, you know. So anyway, so he's saying, you know, let them seek out the Lord. He's close to them, whoever wants him. So
we'll
pray for Yahya. Ismail, did you hear that? Yahya? I know you don't understand Arabic, Yahya, but he said that he's going to pray for you, Yahya. And I see what you do over at Speaker's Corner. We're praying for you and all of those Dawah Genghis.
احنا بنحبكم عندناش كراهية.
We love you. We're not against you.
يعني ربنا قال لنا اذا انت حبيت حسين قريبك ولا صديقك مالكش فضل في كده. مع حسين ده قريبك وصديقك وشريكك في... لكنك تحب عدوك هذا هو المسيح الحقيقي. ده اللي يتابع يسوع فعلا. فاحنا بنحبكم فعلا من قلوبنا.
We love you from our hearts. Jesus told us, you know, it's easy to love sometimes people who are close to you, think like you, but Jesus said, love your enemies too, those who don't love you. And we love you, no matter what you say about us, no matter what you think about us, we love you. And we want you to know the glory that we've known. We were like you. We came from the same background that you are. Same way you are now, we were like you. But Jesus came and gave us real life. We taste the sweetness of Jesus. So come to him. Okay, he's going to pray for you right now. He's going to pray for Yahya, you guys.
يا رب يسوع المسيح يا من علمتنا أن نأتي إليك أيها الوديع المتواضع القلب أيها الملك الملوك يا من جئت في صورة عبد لترفع عنا عار الخطية بالنديك وبنسألك ما تحرمش حد منك أرجوك يا رب. بولس قال وددت لو أني أنا محروم من المسيح لأجل أنسبائي أقربائي في الجسد. وإحنا يا رب مش عايزين وإخواتنا وأهلنا المسلمين ولا يحيى ولا اللي زيه يتحرم منك يا رب. ما تحرموش منك يا رب. ما تحرموش منك يا رب. إلمس قلبه الآن يا رب. غيره الآن يا رب. اتكلم معاه الآن يا رب. اهزم الشيطان اللي جواه الآن. أنت وحدك الذي تستطيع أن تقهر هذا الشيطان وتعلن مجدك من خلاله يا رب يسوع المسيح. واسقني أنك استمعت واستجبت لك المجد الدائم من الآن وإلى الأبد وإلى ظهر الظهور. آمين. بسم الآب والابن والروح القدس له واحد.
آمين.
آمين.
شكرا دكتور.
شكرا صديقي العزيز.
انبسطت منك اليوم. كان بركة كبير.
وأنا اتبسطت منك اليوم وعودة. أنا جاي لك بقى عشان نخدم في شوارع كاليفورنيا سوا زي الأول.
يلا هاي هم منتظرين. امبارح تعرف طردوني وجابوا لي البوليس وقالوا هذا بيلحق البنات وهذا بيغلب الناس. لكن امبارح صاحب المكان قال لك حق تكون هنا.
الله الله صاحب المكان يسوع.
امين.
وصى صاحب المكان الارضي وقال لك لك حق تكون هنا. أيوة. لنا الحق نقول امين.
امين
امين, أمين. اشكرك صديقي العزيز. ربنا يباركك ويستخدمك يا رب.
انت كمان يا رب. يا رب شكرا. ربي يبارك.
ربنا يباركك. سلام الرب معك.
سلام. Thank you. And thank you for everybody who was with us and for being with us for today. And thank you for all who gave us super chats and all that. And the Lord bless you and be with you. And if you haven't done it, do it now. Say, Jesus, help me. Jesus, forgive me. Just come into my heart. Jesus, help me. Jesus, forgive me. Jesus, come into my heart. يسوع ساعدني. يسوع سمحني. يسوع ادخل قلبي. يسوع سمحني. يسوع ادخل قلبي. We love you. Have a wonderful, wonderful day, you guys.
سلام ربي معكم. آمين.
Thank you.